I'm Will Gatchell, and this is B-Brief, where we break down the week's innovative and sustainable business headlines. Oh, and we'll do it briefly. Today we're covering genetically engineered poplar trees, fully biodegradable sneaker soles, and the rest of the shoe, blockchain smart contracts for subsistence farmers, and aluminum is at a premium. Let's get going. Living Carbon is a California-based startup building better trees. Poplar trees, to be more specific. Dr. Frankenstein would be pretty proud. They added extra genes from algae and pumpkins to make the poplar trees more energy efficient, which lets the trees grow quicker, which means the trees capture more carbon, which helps the planet. Living Carbon's genetically engineered poplars could be very popular, as initial studies showed the genetically edited trees had 53% more above-ground biomass than their non-edited counterparts. The company is working with Oregon State University on a trial with 468 poplar trees, and they have plans to start planting these trees on a massive scale towards the end of 2022. But final boss remains in their way, the Department of Agriculture, which has only approved 2 genetically modified plants to date. Luckily, these poplar trees don't produce pollen, which minimizes the risk of genetically modified pollen crossbreeding with non-modified poplar trees, which is definitely the premise of a few sci-fi horror movies I've heard about. Liar. Okay, movies I've watched. Stephen Mayfield is a surfer and a molecular biology professor at the University of California, San Diego. Oh, he's also the CEO of a biodegradable shoe company called Blueview. He's a modern-day Renaissance man. And I know what you're thinking. Stop thinking those nasty thoughts. Mayfield originally studied algae as a replacement for fossil fuels, but after realizing algae's potential as a biodegradable material, he developed an algae-based biodegradable surfboard.
Nice.
Soon, he partnered with footwear executive Tom Cook to launch a new shoe brand. While companies like Allbirds and Adidas have pushed the boundaries of sustainable footwear, Blueview's fully biodegradable soles are the sole type of its kind. Mayfield and his team engineered both bio and petroleum-based materials to create this sole, which is easily broken down on a molecular level by microorganisms. Interestingly, older shoes were always made with longevity in mind, but now manufacturers are realizing that if people only wear shoes for a few years, there's no need for those shoes to exist 500 years in the future. Great insight, shoe manufacturers. Ready for a sentence you've most definitely never heard before? The Lemonade Crypto Climate Coalition wants to use blockchain technology to automate payouts for subsistence farmers. Okay, the rest of this segment will attempt to explain the previous sentence. Lemonade Inc., an insurance technology firm, has a nonprofit called the Lemonade Foundation. This foundation recently launched a nonprofit called the Lemonade Crypto Climate Coalition. The coalition's goal is to provide insurance for subsistence farmers against climate disasters. Subsistence farming is basically a type of farming in which the farmer is mainly growing crops to feed his or her own family and not selling for massive profits. Spoiler alert, climate insurance isn't new, but subsistence farmers have always struggled with insurance since most of the payouts are in small monetary increments, $10 here, $50 there, you know, which is hard for massive insurance companies, which typically pay out hundreds of thousands of dollars to massive farming operations. Using smart contracts, which are blockchain-based algorithms, LCCC believes they can monitor the weather and other conditions via satellites to automatically pay subsistence farmers when droughts and other disasters affect their crop yields. If, for instance, a drought reaches a certain data-based threshold, the smart contracts could be set to automatically pay the farmers the moment that data reaches the threshold. If you're still confused about smart contracts and blockchain technology, that makes two of us. If you're collecting old cans, shredded cars, and/or factory waste, be careful out there. Aluminum makers are on the prowl. You see, aluminum consumption in the United States increased by 11% last year. And I really get it. I mean, it tastes so good.
What?
Companies are building US plants to produce aluminum for auto, beverage, and other manufacturers. And these manufacturers are increasing aluminum production by focusing on recycling. Creating new aluminum from scrap has grown more efficient over the years. And here's a quick fact to illuminate that point. Melting scrap metal uses around 90% less electricity than producing it in a smelter. While aluminum doesn't carry any show-stopping appeal like electric vehicles or mushroom leather, the United States is one of the world's largest consumers and exporters of aluminum scrap. So this is a pretty big deal. Last year, America exported approximately 2 million metric tons of aluminum overseas, which is the equivalent of 2 million metric tons of copper. Whoa. Well, that's all I have for today. Please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed or tolerated today's episode. And without further ado, it's time for a fun fact. Cue the music. If you're scared of sharks, I get it, really. They freak me out too. But you should also be scared of selfies. Yes, selfies are responsible for more deaths per year than sharks. Just bear that in mind the next time you pick up a selfie stick. Anyways, thank you for watching. Have a great day, week, month, year, decade, and century. See you next week.